Alright, welcome to Mixing Straw Lake Clay. Here we are, it is fall of 2014, and we've got most of the family out, and we're going to town, filling in our walls. Josh grabs the clay slip, throws it in. Audrey breaks up the straw. Make our nice solid. Goes down the tube, being mixed. Fingers just kind of tossed around like we're making salad, putting the dressing on it. And lo and behold, beautiful magic mix coming out the back end. Alright, so we mixed up our straw like clay and we're just going to throw it in our wall. So one of the things that you have to remember is that because it's different than dealing with straw bale, you actually are forming a wall as compared to building one up like Lego bricks. So what we do is we go and we put plywood across wherever our voids are. And so we've got strapped across with our 3/8 inch plywood between our posts and beam that are holding up our roof. And I'm just dumping our load of straw like clay. So you just spread it out. You want to fill up about 2 feet at a time. And I always say if you're not getting dirty, you're doing something wrong. That's the only thing you can do wrong with mixing straw like clay. So something to note in here. On the front end loader of the tractor, what I did was I built a plywood box. And the reason for that is you can put on quite a bit more straw like clay that way compared to just the front end loader. And the stuff is not that heavy, not like carrying gravel or dirt. So it's no problem for weight load on there. But 3/4 inch plywood and it works wonderful. You can get in quite a good chunk load there. So once you get into your wall or into your void, what you want to do is you want to make sure that you push down in all your corners. And I just use my feet. Get into some tight areas where you can't get your feet in. You can use a 2x4, that works really good as well. But you just want to make sure that you're pushing in nice and tight. And if you are a mathematics geek, 40 psi is the magic number. 40 psi gives you about 1.6 R per inch. So let me use my calibrated leg here. Yep, that's 40 psi right there. And again, you really can't do anything wrong on it. It is such a forgiving product. If you crush it too much, what you're going to do is you're going to lose a little bit of your R value, but you're going to have a hell of a lot stronger wall. If you don't pack it as much, you're going to have a lighter wall, better R value, but it's not going to be nearly as strong. So the way that I test it is, when it has some nice spring in my step, I know that I'm at about 40 psi. High-tech scientific. Like I said, most important thing is make sure you crush in your corners. Otherwise, those get to be kind of sloppy and loose. All right, let's go make some more. Okay, so welcome back. We're here on 2 days later after we put our straw like clay into our forms. And I'm just going to remove the form and show you what SLC looks like. So there we go, so you can see that the straw is still wet, but it's perfectly formed and a nice arc, just like we want for curved walls. So it was no effort, you didn't have to bend the bales, you didn't have to tie anything in. And once this cures up and dries, it is going to be rock solid hard. So much, much easier. So this is just close up of the straw like clay here, just so you can see. Beautiful curvature. And incidentally, the reason why we have this wall looking the way that it is, this is actually a window buck. We're going to be setting a window in here, and we're going to be finishing stucco over top of here, coming down. And like I said, beautiful curvature. Very, very simple to do. To do complicated shapes with straw like clay. And ready for stucco as is. You might notice that we also have some 2x2 metal mesh along here, and you might notice it's only where the wood is. And the reason for that is because cement stucco will not stick to wood. Your wood is going to take on moisture, it's going to expand and contract no matter what you do, and stucco does not move, so it's not going to bond to the wood. So you just need to have something that will hold the stucco onto the wood. So we just tie it across with a little bit of mesh right there. So thanks again for joining us today. I hope you, you learned something about straw like clay. And if you have any questions, please, by all means, send me a comment, send me an email, and we can answer it for you. As well, if you're interested in anything else that we're doing here, one thing that I should mention is that right now we're building this completely off of grid. So there's no gas, no propane being burnt for it. This is the power being used for the tumbler is actually being created by our wind and our solar. And so like I said, if you have any other questions, check out the rest of our videos below, and we'll see you soon. Take care.